The Park Ridge Public Library presents. Imagine a world of clean lines and pure forms, a perfection as simple as two champagne glasses tinkling together. It's a universe of nightclubs seemingly floating in space, executive suites overlooking a Manhattan skyline, grand hotels bringing people together, and luxury liners carrying them on romantic trips across the Atlantic. The only class here is first class. Every man has a tux, every woman has the perfect gown, and every conversation is memorable.
Have you seen the well-to-do upon Lenox Avenue on that famous thoroughfare with their noses in the air? High hats and colored collars, white spats and $15, spending every dime for a wonderful time. If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where Harlem blitz? Putting on the Ritz. Spangled gowns upon the bevy of high browns from down the levee, all misfits, putting on the Ritz.
This spring, the Park Ridge Public Library presents SCREEN DECO, your invitation into a world that found its inspiration in the Art Deco movement and went on to become one of the great legacies of Hollywood's golden era. Through feature presentations and short subjects, we'll explore visions of the past and future, created by set designers, costumers, directors, and actors, all those who saw in Art Deco the style for a dynamic new age. The origins of Art Deco began in Europe after the First World War, when artists and thinkers from all disciplines were making deliberate attempts to break from their Victorian past. They wanted a bolder, more unconventional style to accompany new ideas about society and people. Inspiration came from unexpected sources. A fascination with Egypt and other ancient cultures helped to shape the ornamentation of the style. Additional influences came from art movements such as Cubism. The 1925 Paris Exposition saw the first comprehensive display of Art Deco, showcasing hundreds of decorative works. The result on a generation of architects and designers was nothing short of electrifying. New buildings began to feature zigzags, sunbursts, and stepped elements. Interior spaces broke free of the dark, claustrophobic Victorian style and became open and light. In time, the sharp angles of the 1920s gave way to the more rounded lines of the streamlined modern style. With their elegant simplicity, both Art Deco and streamlined modern suggested luxury and progress. By the time the 1939 World's Fair opened in New York, the styles had merged the perfect blend of art and technology, showcasing man and machine in an optimistic world of tomorrow. Hollywood showed a natural affinity for Art Deco from the beginning. Some of the great Hollywood art directors of the 20s and 30s include Cedric Gibbons, who attended the Paris Exposition, Hans Dreyer, Anton Grott, and Van Nest Pugles. Others such as William Cameron Menzies, Richard Day, and Charles D. Hall were also profoundly influenced by the style. It was Paul Glace at RKO who shaped the look of the Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers musicals. With their high-gloss sets and black-and-white decor, these films are the essence of what we now call screen deco. Beyond the sets, objects, and fashion, the human form itself, specifically that of the woman, became identified with this high style. In screen deco, glamorous publicity photos radiate a streamlined beauty of the female form. The body itself becomes part of the surrounding decor, a look epitomized by actresses like Gloria Swanson, Joan Crawford, and Carol Lombard. Busby Berkeley's geometric choreography of the female form in his musical numbers is in the best tradition of the Screen Deco style. His arrangements of showgirls displayed a machine-like precision in films like Gold Diggers of 1933 and Footlight Parade. At its height, Screen Deco presented a world that few in the Depression-era audience could expect to find in real life, but that's precisely what sent people to the movies in droves. Simply entering a movie palace allowed the average person to become part of the fantasy world of Hollywood, as many theaters adopted glamorous Art Deco features for their lobbies, staircases, and seating areas. Even today, Screen Deco speaks to the dreams we've shared as a culture. It isn't about cynicism or hopelessness, but rather transcendence and cultural achievement. It's about looking your best and succeeding, about living the first-class lifestyle and finding your inner millionaire. Experience the magic again starting March 15th as we journey down the Nile with Cleopatra, one of Cecil B. DeMille's finest achievements. Our Dancing Daughters follows on March 22nd, featuring Joan Crawford in all her jazz-edge glory. Then, on March 29th, you'll learn why film censors got overheated about the wild musical Madame Satan. On April 5th, we'll be checking into Grand Hotel, a Best Picture winner starring Greta Garbo, John Barrymore, and Joan Crawford, followed by the rarely seen Penthouse on April 12th. On April 19th, strong-minded woman takes center stage in our double feature of The Kiss and Female. Then on April 26th, a star-studded cast welcomes you to the Art Deco nightclub in Busby Berkeley's musical Wonder Bar. After a week off, our series resumes on May 10th with the ultra-modern horror film The Black Cat. On May 17th, enter the world of fantasy with She, and then on May 24th, take a leap into the future with Things to Come. Finally, before the curtain comes down on May 31st, we'll dance the night away with Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers in Swing Time.